With this the giant pushed his big arms, which looked like tree trunks, except that tree trunks don't wear pink velvet, between the iron bars, and the arms were so long that they touched the opposite wall of the rock passage. Then he extended them as far as he could reach toward our travelers, and found he could almost touch the Scarecrow, but not quite.
"Come a little nearer, please,"
begged the giant. "I'm a Scarecrow."
"A Scarecrow? Ugh, I don't care a straw for a Scarecrow. Who is that bright-colored delicacy behind you?"
"Me?" asked Scraps. "I'm a patchwork girl, and I'm stuffed with cotton."
"Dear me," sighed the giant in a disappointed tone. "That reduces my dinner from 4 to 2, and the dog. I'll save the dog for dessert."
Toto growled, keeping a good distance away. "Back up," said the Scarecrow to those behind him. "Let us go back a little way and talk this over." So they turned and went around the bend in the passage, where they were out of sight of the cave and Mr. Yoop could not hear them. "My idea," began the Scarecrow when they had halted, "is to make a dash past the cave, going on a run."
"He'd grab us," said Dorothy.
"Well, he can't grab but one at a time, and I'll go first. As soon as he grabs me, the rest of you can slip past him, out of his reach, and he will soon let me go because I am not fit to eat." They decided to try this plan, and Dorothy took Toto in her arms so as to protect him. She followed just after the Scarecrow. Then came Ojo with Scraps, the last of the four. Their hearts beat a little faster than usual as they again approached the giant's cave, this time moving swiftly forward.